worthy. Amen. He's worthy of our praise. Amen. Let the church say amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He's worthy. He's worthy. Amen. 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 Well, at this time, I have the assignment of John the Baptist somewhat. I'm going to prepare you the way. Amen. For the word of God, we are preparing you the way. Hallelujah. We have somebody in the house. We have some prophets in the house. We've had a few prophets in the house, but we have an evangelist in the house. There's an evangelist in the house that's ready to bring you a word from the Lord. Amen. Ready to bring you a word from the Lord. So I want you right now to get your hearts, get your minds, get ready. Get ready to receive the word of the Lord. At this time, I introduce to you and present to others our very own evangelist, Alfred Carpenter.
The Lord's name shall continue to be praised. In Jesus' name.
Yes.
Amen. Stand up here.
Yes.
Lord, in prayer.
Father, help us, Lord.
Thank you for this day.
Amen.
And this time, Lord, to be gathered in your house today.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Lord, we keep your greatest two commandments.
Yes.
By loving you with everything that you know, all our heart, our mind, our soul, everything.
Yes.
And God, we pray by the move of the Holy Ghost, we will begin to love our neighbor
yes.
the same way.
Amen.
And Jesus, you said yourself,
yes.
if we could keep these two commandments,
yes.
we have kept them all.
My
and
Lord.
At the end of the day, we want to hear you say, well done, my good and faithful servant.
Yes.
Enter into the joy of the Lord.
Yes.
In Jesus' name,
Jesus.
We receive that and we count it done. And we say amen.
Amen.
Shout hallelujah.
Two more
times. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you. You may be seated.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Welcome everybody to the conference house again.
Amen.
I've always loved to do a welcome. I got it from my mom. She was one of the greatest hospitality ladies you ever wanted to meet. She'd make a bowl of collard greens or just eating cabbage and cornbread. Tastes so good, you'd think that she was in heaven. She was just that great. Amen. She had it going on. The simplest thing. But today, to the pastor of this church, Pastor Paul, and do we have any visiting ministers in the house? Raise your hand. Any officers, prophets, you have a prophet, Dallas Cobbs. Good morning. Thank you for being here. God bless you. Is there any other ministers in the house? And to the Cobbs House ministers.
Amen.
And we just a small bunch. Let me tell you, I'm going to talk about you today. I'm going to tell you what God is saying about you. Amen.
Get on, bro.
All right. God, since we just a small bunch, you all are ministers.
Amen. Come on now.
And you're going to be ministers above the regular pew ministers. You are that Gideon bunch.
Amen. All right.
Some of you kind of know it in your spirit right now, but it's right there at the edge for you to step into it and start doing your ministry.
Right.
Amen. Right. The evangelist is in the house today.
Come on.
Amen.
Yeah.
Look, and I got that spirit upon me that I had in 1998.
Come on now. All
right. 1998 was a very different year. It was a very special year.
All right.
1998 was the year of Jubilee. It happens every 50 years. It comes on the 48s and the 98s.
Wow.
Amen?
Right.
And I heard Minister Mike talk this morning about his age. Well, look, I'm old enough to know better. I know some things. Amen?
Right.
I've been through some things. Amen?
Amen.
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 So, Jubilee. You can't use with Jubilee. No matter how many mistakes you made, how much you got into debt, how much unforgiveness and did wrong you do. No matter if you did, in those days, if you fornicated, they were killing you. So if you managed to fornicate and they didn't find out about it, all the stuff you lost, all the stuff you got into, every 50 years, it will restore it to you again. You can't lose when you use Jesus' law, God's law. You cannot lose. Amen?
Amen.
So this is what we want to do. Recently, there have been four speakers in the house. About a month ago, our very own Pastor Pope spoke on unity in the body of Christ. Okay? Then another speaker came on the scene and said, pay your tithe. And it said, you're going to have a new building. And it said, there's some ministers going to come out of this ministry. And it says, there's a blessing season for the ministers in this house. And they said something to us that you need to get in line with this because you might be left behind. You'd be left behind or you'd be left out. There was another a prophet who came and said, wake up, you're sleeping. You're right in the middle of a blessing, but you're not paying attention. Okay. And then a bishop came through and said, what thief are you? We are all a thief. Some thieves have received Jesus Christ. They're on the right hand side. There are some thieves, they show the picture that they received Jesus Christ, but they really have not. They got some ulterior motive. So what thieves are you? Are you willing to be the thief that truly repented and received Jesus Christ? Are you still the same thief that, look, why don't you just save me so I can go back in the world and do wrong again? Why don't you just save us all so I can go fun? So what thief are you? There are some thieves up in the church. It seems that they are doing good, but they got the wrong motive. Amen. They want to get ahead of the pastor. They want to get ahead of somebody else. They want to be the big star. But, as Brother Bowen used to say one time, it's not about us. It's about Jesus Christ. We want to give him the glory. You can't give God the glory if you're trying to get it all about you, secretly. Now, all those messages you've heard, and see, today I want you to look at me as your big brother. I'm the smallest man in the house, but I'm your big brother. My name is David. He had all them brothers bigger than him, but they weren't the man that he was. They couldn't slay nobody. Now, that was an accusation made, these people come in the house speaking like that. And because I love you so much, I want you to know what's going on. I don't believe in no parents fussing with somebody and the child don't know why mom and dad are fussing at you. I don't want mom and dad to come in the house and be saying some things and children don't know what's going on. I'm not going to whoop my child without telling them what I'm whooping them for. If I bless my child, my last daughter, I blessed her one time. And I told her while I was blessing her. I said, Joy, her name was Joy. I said, Joy, I'm blessing you because you had good sense to get out of Dallas before the storm came, to get out of Houston and go home to Dallas before the storm came. So I'm blessing you because you had good sense. So let's be about blessing somebody because we're doing well. Let's get away from that mentality. Because you poor, we want to get away from that. That ain't for the carpenter's house.
Amen.
The carpenter's house is an oracle in the Lord. It's a strong tower. Amen. I'm speaking prophetically. And it is now. Now, the title of this message today is Be Strong in the Lord.
Amen.
Because we've had so much word. And we're going to continue to get word. This is a word, church. Because we live by the word.
Amen.
Can't nothing move or go without the word.
Amen.
God, the Father, got a will. But ain't nothing happen until the word said so. And the word can only say the will of the Father. And then it still ain't moved yet. The Holy Ghost got to come, which is the power of God. The Holy Ghost can only hear the word of God. The word of God can only do the will of God. That's three and four. It takes death for anything to be. It takes death to straighten anything out. The will, the word, and the Holy Ghost.
Amen. Amen. Good stuff. That's good.
Amen.
Good.
Now,
yes, sir.
Cousin's house? And is there any visitors in the house? I'm talking to you too. You can take this home with you.
Yes, sir. Good.
Did you hear Brother Elder Bowen talk about this morning our nations?
Yep.
And did you hear Brother Mike about Sunday school?
Yeah.
Carpenter's house. These folks been talking at you but I'm your big brother. We got growing pains. You 5 years old now. Your mamas and daddies that got children that's 5 years old, they think they know how to answer the telephone. They want to go answer the front door. They want to do a lot of stuff. Get their stuff in the way. They know just enough to get in trouble. Growing pains. I can read the writing on the wall. I can read what you don't say. I can read what I hear you say. I ain't bragging. I've been to school for it. And God has always given me ever since I was young. We got growing pain. We know just enough to get in trouble. Eve knew just enough. All she knows was what she wanted. But she never thought about it. It's going to cost you. She's the mother of all. She just didn't know. She going to call all to have a pain. But it was God's plan. Amen? Carpenter time, we have growing pain. Now, in my regular occupation, I am a maintenance man. Mostly, I am a preventive maintenance man. That fix something before it get broke. Amen? Because when it get broke, you got to shut the whole thing down. Amen? Oh no, that's why the admiral is here today. You know, I wear the captain's cap. Not just because it's cute, but I've been through some things. This is my fourth time being in a ministry as a grown man and a minister at the same time where the church had growing pains. I've been there and we have loved that boat out before. We'll be levered out by the word of God. Not what he think, or what she think, what the pastor think. It's what God said. The will of the Lord must be done. We are men, and we're supposed to have thought. Before we move out, we need to get the word from the Lord. We need to get in the Holy Spirit. We need to seek counsel. The wise man seek counsel. So come to the house, we got growing pains. But this ship ain't going down. It's standing up. Yeah. You got too many word folks in this house that we gonna live by the word. So this is why these folks been saying these things to you. Let us not be guilty of any one of them. Make your mind up now. Check yourself before we wreck. You ain't gonna wreck though. There's gonna be too much prayer going on. There's gonna be too much intercession going on. You can't fail. Said, look up at Jesus. Get in the right company. There's the Father. There's Jesus. The Holy Ghost. How you gonna fail? Do not be afraid. Every time Jesus come out, the word come out, the angel of the Lord can say, wait, say, be not afraid, but be full of joy. Know this, that you will finish everything that I've called you to do.
That's right.
Amen. And he had a scripture this morning. Which one of these preachers had? About second, was the first one of us? 7:14? What was it? I did it on purpose. I ain't preaching by myself. We are together, Pastor Poulos.
All
right, that's good.
All times. Up here, down there, in the street, at home, all the time. Don't stop. We are not alone. We got the fathers and the Holy Ghost and each other. All the time.
Unity.
See, he preached that message. I was listening right at him. Did you hear him? Amen. And there's listen to this. There's a spirit in the house. When you got growing pains, sometimes you want to get quiet. And then sometimes you don't want to praise the Lord. Amen. But let good sense overrule your fear. Let good sense. Let the word. See, we know more what's right to do than we're willing to do it. We know more right thing to do than our mind will let us do it. I ain't doing this because, oh Lord, let me get this. Let us stay in the spirit of the Lord because the spirit will have you do right whether you feel like it or not. You don't feel like going to work, but you get up and go because you wrote that paycheck. Come on, screen, right? Let's go to ball number one.
First play.
And somebody watch my time. You know, sign one out, I can make a touchdown quick. Now, what Jesus is saying to you. As many as I love, I rebuke and chasten. Now, y'all, be zealous, therefore, and repent. If you got all to give somebody, repent. And if you know, if you ain't getting anybody wrong, but somebody did you wrong, don't hold it against them. And then, show forth the joy of the Lord when you see them.
Amen.
Come on, scream. Let's go, scream, baby. Next one. Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man hear my voice and open the door, I will come into him and will sup with him and be with him. I'm knocking on the door today with my message. I'm knocking on the door every Wednesday night. I'm knocking on the door every time you come into the house of God. Every time you come to Sunday school. Every time you hear the word of God. Every time somebody say, good morning, I'm knocking on the door. Will you receive my love? My love from one to another. I'm knocking. And I want to come in and sup, sit down and eat and drink with you. I want to come out, let God come on in and be friends with you. I want to call you my son. That's how much I want you. Too many received me, they became sons of God.
My Lord. Yes.
Come on, screenwriter.
Amen.
To him that overcometh, will I grant to sit with me in my throne, even as I also overcame and sat down with my Father and his throne. If you hear my words today and overcome your growing pain and tongue some of that stuff loose, that ain't worth a dime, no way.
Yeah.
The crown for you is much more greater than that pity you hold on to. Don't you end up in hell with your pity. Don't you end up suffering with that little small stuff like she didn't speak to me. Oh, some little small stuff. The crown is too great. The call on the carpenter's house is too great. Bad ministers got to come out of here.
Amen.
Bad school got to come out of here. That's an awful of a church. When the monarch get in trouble, they go house to send for the carpenter's house. Give me a minister from there.
Yeah.
Send me out.
Yeah.
They go to my house to fast and pray. And say, cut me loose, this one and that one. And go do the work of the Lord. Yeah. Do you know how many ministers in this church are in theological college?
Yeah.
That are making 4.0s. That ain't for nothing. That ain't doing it because it's cute. It's a calling of the Lord.
Yeah.
It's the will of the Lord being done.
Yeah.
And look at the great folks that's in here. You just think you just won the pew. Wrong, baby.
Come on now.
Give yourself 6 more months.
Free.
Stay on board.
That's right.
This boat's going to bounce out.
Thank you. Glory.
Come on, scream right. Throw the ball.
Yes, sir.
He that has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit said unto the church.
Amen.
Who is the church? We are the church.
Yes. Yes.
Overcoming now. That's 3:22. That's in the book of Revelation. Anybody ever read the book of Revelation? It's kind of fearful, ain't it? You know when you think about Revelation, you know God ain't playing, don't you? You know your grace. Everybody know. You don't know very many scriptures, but you say Revelation. They know God ain't playing. They don't want to fool with that. They know God ain't playing. But the truth of the matter is, you're gonna get it here because you need to know the truth so we can handle the situation. God said, don't you be afraid. If he said, don't be afraid in Genesis, he means don't be afraid in Revelation. You have to have Revelation so you can do the world some good.
Oh, this is good preaching.
Yes, sir.
Hear the my time. I ain't playing. I'm going to stop when it's time to stop.
I got your clock. Take your time.
Amen.
Go ahead, Elder.
Now,
preach, Elder.
I want to remind you and exhort you that, look at what we have. Come on, screen, give me the next one, number two. We got about eight of them. We're going to put it on. We're going to go.
Amen. Already made five first downs.
Give me all. John, screen runner. John, John.
Amen.
We all loaded up. We just stepped out a little bit. We're going to the other side.
All right now. Talk about it.
Now, this is the first thing you need to remember. Remember who you are. God will tell you who you are and who he is. He said, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life.
Yeah.
Yeah. Remember that you're saved. Yeah. Remember that all y'all have received Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
Even if you got some bad habits, some good habits, some out habits, some up habits, whatever you got, you're saved.
That's right.
And I remember when Pastor Pope was preaching about when you get saved, you go, when you really saved, you saved. I saw the release of freedom on so many people's faces. Because some people were scared to death that they were going to hell. And they saved all time. I've been in this thing for some years. I can say that. I can watch the Spirit move. And I felt so good that he preached on that and he gets it now. Ain't it good to know that you're saved?
Yeah.
Ain't it good to not be saved?
See you. Amen.
So remember that you're saved. Come on, screenwriter. Now, then what God talked about you. See, we talk about each other. But let's see what God say about us. That's what counts. That's the thing that counts. It said, but ye are a chosen generation. Today, no matter how bad fornication going on, you who received Jesus Christ, to my that generation, but you are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood. No, let's go together. Come on, let's go together. Say, but ye are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, and holy nation, a peculiar people that should show forth the praise of him who has called you out of darkness into his father's life. All of us have been called out of darkness. When you got bone, you was bone in darkness. No matter how big or how small you were, we are all was bone in darkness. When you call upon Jesus, you're facing grace face to face. Grace lets you live. Grace give you another chance. Grace forgive. Grace that do what? Say it with, what it is, Christian?
Restore.
Grace that do what?
Restore.
Grace that do what?
Redeem.
Grace that what?
Release.
Miracle. How you got what you got? It was God's grace. When these people say, they ain't saying it just because they're cute. They're saying the word of God. And the pastor will come and preach the word of God. And all of us should live our lives showing forth the love of God.
Yes.
It's all about who wrote it.
Yes,
Jesus.
Yes,
come on, screen writer. Third of all.
Yes, Lord.
Yes,
for God has not given you the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and a sound mind. You ain't got no business being crazy.
That's right.
You are not supposed to be crazy. You're supposed to have good sense. Even though you're born as a crack baby or drug addiction.
Amen.
God is out here when you receive Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Of what? Giving us the spirit. The spirit overrules the body. That's the number one.
Yeah.
The body can't move unless it comes to the spirit first.
All right.
It's spirit, soul, and body.
Yeah.
It comes in your spirit, then they got to come to your mind. Some of us need to clean our mind up.
Yeah.
Get the filth out of your mind.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
And sound man. Now, let's talk about fornication. Them things we ain't supposed to be thinking about. We're not going to be thinking about it. Cast it out, humble man.
Cast it out.
That's what God has given you. He said you're chosen people. You're special. He should not engage you something. Come on, screenwriter. For the weapons, you got something too. For the weapons of our warfare are not common, but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. Was that one or two of them? Give me the next one. Hold it one time. Casting down. What's in your mind? Cast it down. Casting down imagination and every high thing that exalts itself against the mind of God, and bring it into captivity, every thought to the obedience of Christ. What you gonna think about the wrong stuff? Spit that out of your mouth. It don't belong to you. And you cast them down. I ain't doing that. Now, there's some addiction that's hard to get rid of. But thank God that you saved. And you fight that fight, the good fight of faith. And you never quit. Because God knew your heart. I know some people got some addiction, but they ain't giving up. They ain't giving up. And they have gotten to the point. You know, sometimes I told you before, I was a grace preacher. I've got the people to understand something about grace. You got to let folks love you, and you got to love folks. You got to let other folks say something nice to you. You got to let other folks love you. Can't you see when somebody loves you and care about you? Why are you clowning and acting all insane with them? They love you. They're trying to give you something, do something for you. But see what happened? You ain't forgave. You hold on to something. So it's going to make you act unseemly because you ain't forgave.
Come on, man.
Yeah, come on. Say that, Lord. Didn't I tell you I wasn't preaching by myself? This whole house is one big preacher. Come on, screenwriter. Throw the ball. And listen here. Come on, let's go. Say this with me. Many are the affliction of the righteous, but the Lord delivers out of them all. What's your problem? You ain't gonna have it always.
All right.
Who is true? God's true or you?
God.
All right. Well, who true? God. God. Whose report are you going to believe? God. What you think or what God say? Come on, screenwriter. Roll.
Amen. Woo, we have to go online.
And look, they preach about Paul and Silas. What did Paul and Silas do at midnight? Say, come on, let's read it. Sing unto the Lord, O you saints of his, and give thanks at the remembrance of his holiness, for his anger endureth a moment, and his favor is life. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Listen, let me tell you when the morning comes. It ain't several hours from now when the sun comes up. It's when you change your mind. No, let me say it. There ain't no light in that stinking bed. That's when the morning comes. When you repent. When you forgive. When you decide to love. When you decide to do the will of God. Of the Lord. That's when the morning comes. That's a new day. Coming out. We got growing pain. You ain't going there. We got to overcome this growing pain.
Amen.
All the nice things spoken about. The pastor Pope. I've heard some things spoke about it. There's some people don't know what to call him. He's a son to some of the churches up there in Houston. I seen him go to Louisiana. He's a big brother to them folks. I saw him go right into him. He's an altar. I'm not exalting my pastor. I'm telling the truth.
Amen.
And I ain't ashamed to tell it.
Amen.
And I ain't no yes man. Never been. And never will be. But I can roll the truth straight down the aisle. And that's all the pain. And I'm going to tell y'all something, ministers coming aboard. We don't want to see you up too close to Pastor Pope. No. It ain't but one man that can be that close to a pastor.
Yes,
he has got to be a John. Like John laid his head on Jesus' breast. If he ain't that, he's a backstabber. If he ain't John, I'm talking about the John that wrote the book of Revelation. I'm talking about the John that wrote the book of St. John. I'm talking about the John that wrote John 1, 2, and 3. That John! If he ain't that John, Pastor, he out of order. He cannot get that close to you. Or she! And I guess you women say, but that ain't no she. The women don't do that. She can get that myself. So you gotta check yourself and say, am I talking to the pastor too much? And then check myself. Some of you women will say, I'm gonna call Sister Jack before I call him. And see, there's other grown women that are outstanding ministers in this ministry. You need to call some of them too. Don't wear her out!
Instruction in the house.
Yeah.
Free right or wrong. Now, to give body of Christ to all of us, this is out the book of Colossians. It's fruit straight to the church. When the church had problems in growing brain. Big time. I'm setting it ready to know us today. It said, for this call. Now look, this, get this good, because there's some instruction in here.
Yeah.
It said, for this call, we also, since the day we heard it, since the day you was called and got your ministry started,
right.
Do not cease to pray for you.
Yeah.
God is your intercessor prayer. Make it ever make an intercessor for you. Interceding for you. That's who's talking to you now. And to pray for you. And to desire that you might be filled. Now this is what God wants for the church. To desire that you might be filled with knowledge. Why do you think we're going to school? If Bible says somebody to get some knowledge. Be filled with the knowledge of his will and wisdom and his spiritual understanding. You got to know God's will. That's what we want. We're supposed to want something. We are supposed to have some feeling. We're supposed to have some thoughts. But before you move out on it, let's check with the Holy Ghost and see if this in line with God's will. You can know God's will because you can find some words from Scripture at least three times before in the Bible that agrees with it.
Amen.
Amen.
You need this knowledge to know God's will. Wisdom is knowing God's will.
Yes.
Solomon said, I know I got this kingdom. I got all the windows my eyes can see. But God, give me some wisdom.
Please. Hello.
Please.
Brother screenwriter. That you might. See, he wants you to do something with it. When God gives you something, it ain't just for you to have your laptop. So,
right.
Oh, I pray.
Yeah.
You got to do something with it. Because if you don't, he going to get mad at you.
Yeah.
If you don't show your talent, that you might walk worthy of the Lord. Unto all pleasing, being fruitful, doing something, and adding good work, not bad work, and increasing in the knowledge of God. You keep my people perish due to the lack of what?
Knowledge!
Come on! God said that. Don't you see he keep telling you, get some knowledge? Come on, we are getting knowledge. We're getting it. So don't let this small stuff rock the boat too much.
Come on.
That's good.
That's real good. Look at the good stuff.
Yeah.
Look at the prosperous stuff.
Yeah.
Look at the good stuff.
Yeah.
Don't let the devil beguile you like he told Eve in the garden. The devil said, Eve, God didn't tell y'all the full truth. Don't let folks in the congregation or who you're working with, don't let them fool you and say, Sally said this, John said this. No. No, don't you receive none of that. We're going to see what the Word of God says.
Yes.
We're going to live in the Spirit.
Yes.
Yeah. Don't get to rock the boat. Because the devil trying to steal from you by making you fuss with each other.
That's right.
By making you not trust each other.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Some people get up and say, I don't know about you. But this brother here said, I know about you.
All right.
I know about us. All of us want to get into a good church. We want to get a good pastor. Some of us want to get in and go to work. Some of us just want to do a good thing. But we want to get into a good church. Where are you going to find one if you let the devil steal from you and separate you and you don't trust each other? Where are you going to go to church? If you start some mess in here, where are you going to go to church at? Where are you going? You ain't got nowhere to go. A good church is hard to find. You can't always find a good church. They're hard to find. Because something wrong big somewhere. But the project ain't going with the worms, he's still in the money. Oh, he's doing stuff. These days, he's fine. He's a, what the word is going to be? Yeah, he's fine. I don't know even the bad name.
A first man, they call him.
A false man, yeah.
First man.
And then, you need to get into a church where the pastor's preaching, y'all get married.
Come on, man.
Because that is what's right to do. That is God's will to do.
Amen.
And grace will give you time to get it all together. When you get your heart, your mind in line with what God's will, he'll bless you with the finances that you need. He'll heal different things in the area. And let you stay in church and get it together. And you'll be so happy. Come on, screen right around. Strengthen. Now look, after this, he don't want no whip. He wants you to be strong. Strengthen with all might. In spirit, soul, and body. In the word, in everything. In all the fivefold ministry. In all the fruit of the spirit. He wants you to be strengthened with all might according to his glorious power. Unto all patience and long suffering and joyfulness. Look, y'all better start saying praise God. I sit right here in the midst of us. And we ain't been praising God like we used to do. Let's sing the song. Deacon, you don't deep like you used to do. You don't sing like you used to sing. But congregation, you ain't praising God like you used to praise God. You ain't saying amen. There was a time when Pastor Pope had to tell the brother, y'all sound, let me preach. Sister Deacon can come up here and give some announcement. All she's doing is giving an announcement. But we get so enraged and gone on in. She said, yes, I got three more now. Y'all sit down. Get back in. There's something happened in the ministry that rocked the boat. But you like to say the devil is a lie?
Yeah.
He has a roaring lion. Going around. This lion ain't got no teeth in his mouth. He just roared. And when you, oh Jesus, come on, see me.
Yes.
Throw the ball. Now this is what we ought to be doing. Because you ain't perished yet, and you're still getting the word, you're still getting fed, you're still living. You need to what? Give first unto the Father, which has made us meet to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints in life. He always tells you, I got a crown. Don't you know you're not going to ever die? You can't fathom it, everlasting life. But just believe as his word.
Yeah.
That you're going to live. Swing right around. Give thanks. I'm going to have some thank the Lord in here.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord.
Pray
amen.
Now, do you want to be blessed? It said, let's read this together, y'all. Come on. Blessed is the man that endures temptation, for when he is tried, he shall receive the crown of life, which the Lord has promised to him that loves him. This ain't for nothing. Now I'm getting it closer.
Thank you, Lord.
Now, I just don't know how to answer.
Yes, sir.
Big brother taught me today.
All right. Amen. Amen. Amen.
I say you got growing, we got growing pain.
Yeah.
But we're going to be overcome. Like the temptation, we're going to overcome the growing pain.
Yeah.
All
right.
That's the crown of life.
Yeah.
Individual life, life of the whole church while we're in this earth. Now listen. Now here's the three main things to do when you got a growing pain. The first thing you need to do, you need to get on your post. All of us. From the pastor on down, let us get on our post
right.
And do what we're supposed to be doing.
Right.
And after you get on your post, stay in your lane.
All right.
Get out of other folks' business.
Yeah. Amen.
Quit looking at, he ought to be doing that.
Yeah.
And you ought to be doing that.
Yeah.
Well, I think they should do this. And I think they should do that. Wrong. It ain't your thoughts, no way. It's
right.
The will of the Lord that will prevail.
Amen.
Yeah. Many have to plan in the main heart. But it's the Lord's will that will come to pass.
Yes.
Yes.
In this church, we have several activities, things going on.
Yes, sir.
If you want to work in one of them, go to the head department and say, look, can I help? Would you give me a party? Ask them. If they don't come to you, say, go ahead and ask them, can I help do this? Can I help? Let me help. Which is what you're supposed to be doing. Offer your service. Render your service.
Amen.
Don't wait till somebody come and ask you all the time.
Yeah.
How would you feel if you had to ask your husband, do you love me, baby? Or would you feel better if he automatically tell you from the front, I love you? Which one do you want? So, if you got to ask for it three times and then find the folks that he tell you, you might not want to hear. And then, if some of the people working here to come actually do something,
yeah.
Stop saying, well, I can't do this. Would you say, well, I'll do what I can. Will you help me, show me?
Yeah.
Well, don't say, I can't, I don't, well, they're anointed to do what they're doing.
Yeah.
They can show you and teach you. Everyone that's getting part of here is anointed.
Amen.
All right.
If they actually, they're anointed to teach you.
Yeah.
They're anointed to get you going. And the third thing is get on your post, stay in your lane, and support the welfare of the church. Support the will of the church.
Amen.
Brother Bone said this morning about our country. Support the general welfare of our country. For the Covenant's house, support the God-given will for this church.
Yes.
Don't tear nothing down.
Yes.
Right. Now, come on, man, stuff.
Amen.
Sometimes the pastor can say something that you might not agree with. No, let me talk this straight. He says some things sometimes that we all don't agree with. Because we all are human. He got thoughts like we got thoughts. I mean, if my thoughts can get in the way, so can his. But before we make a move, we want to see what the Holy Ghost gonna say. And if you thought he missed it, don't you get mad at him. He's a man, but he's trying to do the will of the Lord with his whole heart. You got the Bible. Everybody in the Bible. All the outstanding folks in the Bible. The great ones. They missed it every now and then. But they got them to heaven. Don't you prefer going to hell because you hate on somebody. So quit expecting him to hit it every time. And oftentimes, he hits it. It ain't him, it's you. He can say something that's as straight as can be. And you say it's wrong. Oftentimes, it ain't him, it's you, mister. You wouldn't receive the word of God. And listen. When a man's there preaching, the preacher that's called by God, when he has been preaching, you know what this represents? The throne of God. You see this cross on here? It ain't that just cause it's cute.
Yeah.
You're just like Jacob with his ladder. God's word coming down to the pastor is like a ball. So he's going to say what he's supposed to say. God has given him to say to the people that's in the audience. I'm coming to the college house today. I ain't talking about no folks over in India or nowhere else. I'm not talking to the folks in the other part of LaMarque. I'm talking right here, 3500 Gulf Freeway. Pastor Ron Pope, senior pastor. I'm talking to this group. What good would it do if I'm here preaching and I'm talking about somebody else somewhere else? He don't do that. When God will tell you something, he tells you. He tells to the congregation, and God know who going to be here.
Yeah.
Now, sometimes I feel like when Pastor Pope was preaching, the other preacher, I said, that's the folks should be here, but they ain't here.
Yeah.
It's God's business.
That's right.
And some of it is for you sheep to go get it straight with them folks that ain't here. Because
yeah.
You know enough word to get it going.
That's right.
All right. The bed is in the house today.
Yeah.
Now, I used to make you laugh, but I ain't playing here. Let them be praising. Let them be praising the house of the Lord. Let them be some Thanksgiving. Now, you got some three words here. Revival, restore, redemption. We must have these three things. Revive, that means you're alive. But the blood in the veins is flowing again. And one thing that'll get the blood flowing is the word.
Yeah.
In the blood is the word. And we got to receive that word to be revived. Here's another word. Restore. Restoration.
Amen.
A country boy, we should have revival, you say. We should have revival in the country. And there's a while before I really understand what revival was for. We thought it was just about getting salvation. But revival is to the body of Christ that's got growing pain.
Right.
Revival is to the folks that's already saved.
Yeah.
It's kind of weaving and walking.
Yeah.
Revival is for the folks that saved that need to be strengthened.
Yeah.
They need to be refreshed.
Yeah.
Revival is for the folks that's already saved. They need to check themselves and go around and forgive some folks.
Yeah.
There's revival for the same folks that saved. They need to go show the love of God to some folks. Because you got, they ain't got. Listen, revival is refreshing you. You know, we got folks that have to live on drugs. They take medicine every day in order to have some kind of balance of good sense. Equilibrium. We know this. We know about us. There's plenty of folks taking pills. Got a purse full of pills. Got pills. But these people, don't shun them people. You have to show the love of God to everybody. If they're a little bit off, we all are off because we're all born in sin. Some of us are just on a little bit different level. That's the truth. You're all born in sin. You ain't got all your screws. You ever been going all the way to the top? Because if it did, you wouldn't be on this earth. When sin hit the earth, everything in it is imperfect. So, when you revive something, I got you. After you revive something, you're supposed to do something with it. You're supposed to restore it. Put it back in use. Don't make me feel good and I feel all better and I don't get up and go to work. When you sit, you down, you take medicine, and you get revived, what you do? You get up and go back to work. When there's an alt in the church, somebody has to sit down, somebody has to shut up, somebody has to change the way they dress, somebody has to do something different. It hurts their feeling. Let's wash them up, rub some healing balm on that thing, because this is God's will. God is love. Love will heal a multitude of what? Sin. Now who right? The word of God right? Or what you think? So what you gonna do? You got to do something with it. You got to run the healing bomb in it. We get mad at folks because they do some stupid stuff. My God, why she gonna do this for? She's still a child of God. Now, when something goes wrong, because this is a world church, there must be a montuitous on the person that ain't doing right. They need to come up with some more understanding, because some of us got a lot of understanding about something, and we just got enough knowledge to be crazy, to do something stupid, because we think we know something, and you hurt somebody else's feelings. It's got to be a balance. And if you're educated, be educated enough to not go too far beyond the folks that's with you. You're no stronger than the weakest link. The chain is.
That's right.
All
right.
That's good. That's good.
This man is a doctor, but he got somebody that don't know John 3:16. You ain't, because you're a doctor, you still got somebody that don't know John 3:16. Bring it to a balance. Bring that ship to a balance. You don't have the scriptures about the man that mistreated his wife, and God said, I ain't asking you a prayer because you're mistreating your wife. Yeah. How you think he feel when you're mistreating your son or your brother?
Yeah.
Let's balance this boat. And what we do, we're going to shed it off. We must get back to praising God. I used to tell Christine, it took a long time before she understood what I meant. I said, Christine, change our mind. Christine, I want you to change my mind. She didn't know what I meant. I'm much more older than she is in the gospel. When she sang, she get the ground ready for you to preach. When she sang, you tenderize people's heart and their mind.
Yeah,
you soften them up.
Yeah, yeah.
So when the preached word comes, the seed goes into hot, fertile ground. Change their mind, Christine. Get their mind ready. That's what you're doing, Brother Rob. Get them ready. Hot courses is a great deal in the sight of the Lord. But they get them ready. Because if they ain't ready, you all look like shooting bullets in a steel wall. Praise team, not just Christian, you too. People sitting out in the pew, when people come in, love upon them. Talk to them. Hey, how you doing, girl? You know what to say. Come on, Fred. Don't you know what to say? Yeah, she know what to say. Don't we betray? Don't we know how to say? I brought my friend girl from California here, not from North Carolina, she, and I set her right side of the trees. She a tall, silhouette like a tree. I set her right, I brought her right there, side of the tree. Set her right there. I said, take care of my friend. She took care of her. She talked, she had good. Y'all know what the trees gonna do to you. She gonna talk to you. She's going to find out who you are, where you come from, what do you want to know? Listen. And find out that you're from North Carolina. Who else is here from North Carolina? Mike. See, listen. This is what we have to do, get in the spirit. It's not by might. It's not by hot power, but you must have the spirit of the Lord.
Yes,
amen.
Yes,
come on, stand to your feet.